Hey everyone, it's Amanda, and in today's video, I am spilling my winged liner hack. I used it today to create this smoky brown winged eyeliner look, and I'm so happy with how it turned out. I think it is so pretty, and honestly, guys, it was so easy. This look is so beginner friendly, and I honestly used a lot of really affordable products in today's look. But before we get into it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and also hit the bell notification so you don't miss any future videos from me. It would really help me out a lot, and your support means so much to me. So without further ado, let's get into the tutorial. I'm so excited to show you how to achieve this smoky brown chocolate eyeliner look. As you can see, obviously I've completed one eye. I just wanted to make sure I had all my steps in order and everything was going smoothly before I fully committed. But yeah, I'm so happy with how this turned out. This is honestly so easy, so beginner friendly, and honestly, a lot of the products I use today are really affordable. So without further ado, let's hop right into it. So this first step is really important. This is a key component to the whole eyeliner hack. This is something I don't see done a lot. I used to do this all the time in high school, and this honestly just saved me a lot of time and gave me the perfect snatched eyeshadow shape. And the hack is Scotch tape. It works so good, literally. I'll show you how I do it. This is such a good hack. I don't know why more people don't use this hack, because for me, it just saves me so much time. I'm gonna show you how I do this. Before we get into taping my face, I just wanna let you know that I have applied a base on my eyes. I basically just applied a little bit of concealer and set it with powder. You can use whatever eyeshadow base you want. If you want something more full coverage, I recommend the MAC paint pots. They're really good. If you want something more sheared out or even like a clear base, the NARS eyeshadow base is really awesome too. And I believe they're still selling the tinted ones, which are really good. So yeah, there's a few options, or you can just do what I did, a little bit of concealer. Okay, so there is a method to this madness. What you wanna do is you wanna take not too much tape. I don't know if you guys can see this, but about that much. I would say this is like an inch to an inch and a half, maybe. So you're gonna take your tape and you're going to just stick it somewhere on your body. I like to stick it to the palm of my hand, and I just kind of stick it and remove it a few times, just like that. You wanna remove most of the stickiness from the tape because I have makeup applied underneath, so I don't wanna disrupt that makeup. So I find if I kind of just like blot the stickiness off, it doesn't disrupt my makeup at all. So the angle I apply this tape personally is I kind of just like extend my lower waterline up. So I'll kind of just tape it right here, but you can do it more straight, you can do it more lifted. You can pretty much do whatever shape you want. The only thing I will say is just make sure they are even on both sides. So I'm going to be using this eye as a reference. Okay, so I think that is fairly even. Don't be shy to really take your time with this step, because this is kind of the most important step to the eye look. So yeah, I just really press that tape in because it's not that sticky. So you'd really kind of have to like firmly push it in place. But yeah, so basically what the tape is there for is it gives you a really clean edge when you're doing eyeliner or eyeshadow, so you don't have to clean up at the end of your makeup, remove your makeup underneath. It just kind of is like a cheat or a hack for perfect liner, in my opinion. So right off the bat, I'm gonna go in with a neutral brown eyeshadow. I'm using this one from the ColourPop Gone Matte eyeshadow palette, and I'm using the shade Duvet It. This is just a really nice neutral cool tone brown. You can use any kind of light brown shade. This is basically gonna be your crease shade. By the way, don't mind my busted nail. I'm so sad. I broke my nail. I was opening a package and my nails never break. Honestly, it's been a long time since my nail has broken, and I just like twisted it the wrong way and it popped off. Oh, it's just the worst. Anyways, so I'm just gonna take some of that light brown eyeshadow and I'm just going to start mapping out where I'm going to be applying my liner. So I'm really just focusing on the outer corner. Also, I'm just gonna drag this kind of halfway across my lid. I'm not gonna be too precise with this. Obviously, I'm using a nice fluffy brush and I'm just kind of dragging it towards my inner corner, but I will say don't bring any shadow or color too close to your inner corner because that's gonna close off your eyes a little bit. And for this specific look, we're going for a very lifted, elegant, kind of bright eyed effect. So I would just avoid any color on the inner corner unless that's the look that you're going for. Okay, so now that we've mapped out a little bit of a base, we're gonna go right into eyeliner. Today, I'm going to be using the ColourPop BFF Cream Gel Liners, and I actually really love the ColourPop BFF line, I guess it is. I've used the BFF liquid liners as well, and they are so good. I love the Grande liquid liner. It's just like a nice brown liquid liner. It is incredible, and these are honestly so affordable. So yeah, I'm gonna show you how I use these today. So the shade that I'm using to start off is the shade Sunnyvale. This is just a good dark medium brown. I'm gonna kind of use this as the base for my smoky liner. I'm going to apply this pretty close to the root of my lashes. I want this to be fairly thin, not too thick. You can always add more later. That's kind of my motto, just start small. And yeah, I'm just going to start to outline my winged liner shape. And I'm just going to stop applying that liner about halfway across my lid. I'm not dragging it in too far at all. Okay, so we have our base shape. I'm gonna jump right in. I'm just gonna use a really tiny kind of pencil slash smudge brush to blend this out. These don't set down super quickly, but you do wanna work fast. I just feel like you get the best result when you just blend it out quickly. So yeah, I'm just going to be diffusing this shade and blending it out. Okay, look at that. This really did not take me much work at all to blend that out. These liners are surprisingly so creamy and so easy to blend. Like I said earlier, they don't really set super quickly, but I just find that when I jump right in and blend them out, I just get a really buttery smooth blend. So I would just recommend getting right in there. You can use whatever brush you want. You can use a little pencil brush like me, or you can use more of a smudger brush. Whatever you want to just get in there and smudge that liner out, you go ahead and use. As you guys can see, this tape here is really preventing any color from going past where I've applied that tape. So I have a really sharp, crisp line. That is exactly what I want. So you're just gonna wanna make sure your tape stays pretty secure in place while you apply. So just keep an eye on it. So I'm going to be going in with the shade Brouhaha. I think that's what it's called. This is just one shade darker than the previous liner we applied. This is honestly an optional step. You don't have to do this. I just really like the gradient that this makes on the liner. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply this darker shade really even closer to my lash line to kind of create more of an ombre effect. Okay, so that's all I'm going to apply. I'm really gonna keep it really minimal. And again, just taking that same tiny little brush, I'm just gonna go in and blend that shade out. Already, that is looking so pretty, and I really feel like I haven't done much work at all. This has been so, so easy. I'm gonna mix the shades Snoozin' and Powder Puff together in the same ColourPop palette, and I'm just going to use that dark brown shade to really melt those two colors together. I'm just taking a smudger brush and kind of just going right on top of that deeper brown eyeliner shade, just for a bit more of a seamless blend. I think this is looking so, so pretty. And honestly, this has been so incredibly easy and we're pretty much done with the liner. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to tight line. I am going in with my Patrick Ta Precision Gel Liner in the shade Rich Brown. These gel liners, honestly, I haven't found anything that really beats them as far as something that I can wear in the waterline, in my tight line, that honestly and truly just will not budge and will stay all day long. I just like applying these liners in the tight line just to deepen up the lash line a little bit more, just so that we don't see any gap between my tight line and the actual liner. Okay, so now for the moment of truth, I'm going to remove my tape and show you guys what it looks like. Okay, and that is what it looks like with the tape removed. As you can see, my makeup underneath really isn't disrupted at all. I could go in with maybe a little bit of concealer and powder under the eyes if I really want to make it flawless. But to be honest, I'm not too worried about it. I think it looks really good. And as you guys can see, look how snatched my eyeliner is. That line is so crisp. And yeah, I just love the way this tape just does all the work for you. Yeah, I'm just obsessed. I love this tape trick. It just pretty much gives you the perfect snatch look every time. Sometimes there's like a little bit of cleanup you have to do if you didn't stick your tape on right, but most of the time it comes out looking pretty snatched like this. I am going to brighten the inner portion of my eye a little bit. I'm going to take the shade Fluff Up in that same ColourPop palette. And I'm just going to lightly sweep that across my lid and kind of in the inner corner area. I'm just gonna go in with that Duvet It shade right on the outer corner of my lower lid, just kind of blend it together a little bit and kind of just connect the two. Time for a little bit of mascara. I'm going to go in with the L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara. This one is so good. The reason I'm going in with this mascara today is because I want a really thin lengthening coat of mascara before I apply my eyelashes today. So I'm so excited to tell you guys about these lashes. I just discovered them and I kid you not, I think they're the best lashes that I've ever used in my life. And I don't say that lightly. I've gone through a lot of lashes in my day. I love eyelashes, but sad story, I have an allergy to latex. And so I can't really wear eyelashes on a regular basis, which is really sad because I love false lashes. Me personally, I prefer a little bit of a more natural look, but that is why I'm gonna show you these lashes. Okay, so these lashes are by Pseudo Labs. You may recognize them from their Freckles products, but they just recently came out with lashes. These are their Psyllium lashes. They are so beautiful, so beautiful. They have a clear band, which I always love. I personally just, I'm a clear band kind of girl. I think it looks way more natural, way more easy to apply. And the collection of lashes they have are so, so natural. They honestly look like eyelash extensions. I've had eyelash extensions before. They are so beautiful. I love the way they look, but they are a lot of upkeep. And I kind of like removing my lashes at the end of the day. Anyways, I'm rambling. So Psyllium lashes by Pseudo Labs, clear band, synthetic lashes, really natural, just stunning. And this is another part that I'm excited about. They're polymer eyeliners that are basically the adhesive for the lashes. And I'm not allergic to these at all. So they must be latex free completely. They don't irritate my eyes whatsoever, which is shocking because I am so sensitive. Anyways, this is their clear one. I want to try their black and brown shades as well, but I just have this one. My only problem with this clear one is like if you're wearing makeup underneath, the tip gets kind of nasty and dirty looking, but that's okay. So I'm going to show you how I apply this polymer lash adhesive. I basically just apply it like I would any eyeliner, and I just apply it really close to my lash line, just like this. And I kind of just tap it. All right, and then to apply the lash, I just take them on my little lash tweezers and I just plunk them on. I like to start by attaching the outer corner first and then working my way down to the inner corner. Okay, so that is what the lashes look like. Are they not just absolutely stunning and so natural looking? I am just obsessed. I have not been this excited about a product in a really long time. So to finish off the eyes, I'm going to be dipping into my Patrick Ta Major Dimension eyeshadow palette and just using the lightest two shades mixed together as an inner corner highlight. I almost forgot. One more thing I'm going to do is I'm going to apply my Instant Brightening Waterline Pencil by Victoria Beckham Beauty. This is the first time that I'm trying out this liner, so let's see. Ooh, I actually really like that. It didn't stick to my lower lashes at all, but it really did give a nice brightening effect to my eyes. All right, you guys, and that is it. This is honestly such an easy eye look to achieve. Perfect for beginners. If you want a really pretty smoky liner, you can wear this every day. You can also wear this going out. You can kind of adjust it to however you'd like. If you want to try with black or any other color, there's many ways you can play around with this look. And yeah, if you just follow this technique, it will be super, super easy for you. I hope you guys liked my winged liner hack and this smoky chocolate brown winged liner look. If you did like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and also hit the bell notification so you don't miss any future uploads from me. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.